A. Jean Petit taught in the Sarasota County school system for 30 years. After retirement in 2008, she continued her service to the students of Sarasota County by volunteering and substitute teaching in the local elementary schools until her untimely death in 2012. Good morning. I'm Ed James, and welcome to Black Almanac. Ms. Petit taught mainly in high minority population schools, and she believed it to be vitally important to celebrate and share the heritage of people of color. Today's guest, A. Jean Petit Scholarship Committee Chair, Mr. Henry Hank Petit, the First Lady of Light of the World International Church and Scholarship Committee Board Member, Mrs. Delilah Lumpkin, and former scholarship winner, Troy Simon Jr.
In 1926, a distinguished black historian organized the first week-long celebration of African-American history. By the late 1960s, thanks in part to the Civil Rights Movement, the event became Black History Month. In 1976, President Gerald Ford officially recognized Black History Month and urged the public to remember the contributions of Black Americans throughout history. Sarasota's own history is abundant with the achievements of our African American citizens, and I invite you to come learn more about our rich history right here at City Hall throughout the month of February.
I guess it's time once again for the big show. Mr. Petit, tell us about it.
Well, this is our fourth annual A. Jean Petit Scholarship Fundraiser Luncheon. And of course, the scholarship is under the banner of Light of the World International Church. Pastor Kelvin Lumpkin is our pastor. And on the other side of the table is our lovely First Lady, Delilah Lumpkin, who's also a member of our scholarship committee. Mm-hmm. And to the right of her is Troy Simon, one of our essay winners and also scholarship recipient. And as long as he stays in school, he can keep getting money.
Yes,
as long as his grades are up to par.
Yes,
all right. You say essay winner and scholarship winner. Are they not one and the same?
Not exactly. What we do every year, because Jean was so big on black history, we have a black history essay contest that we put out to all the high schools, for all the minority students. And each year they submit essays related to some topic on black history. And our committee chooses the three top students, or the three top essays, and they in fact become our luncheon speakers, as opposed to having a speaker come in. Our essay writers present their essays at the luncheon.
The students submit the essays to us, and then we read them before the actual luncheon, and we determine the winners, actually. And that's an important point, Dr. James, because it's not, the awards are not made based on how they deliver. It's not an oratorical contest. It's really, truly based on the content mm-hmm. of the essays, the depth of thought that they put into them.
Spoken like a teacher.
Yes, sir.
And I understand Troy was a double winner.
Yes.
Yes.
In 2015, when I graduated, I actually wrote my essay for the scholarship. I received second place, which isn't bad. You know, first place is always what everybody aims for, but I got second place. And later on, after I graduated, I applied for the church scholarship, and I got awarded for also that. So basically I won the scholarship money and the scholarship money, which is a big lump sum.
What do you know that the rest of the folk don't know?
I mean, you just have to just go out there and just get every opportunity that you can, you know. You can't just wait on it. You just have to go out and just grasp it, every opportunity that's possible for you.
And where are you in school?
Currently, I'm attending State College of Florida. This is my second year. I'm a AA student right now, so I'm just getting my general studies, but I plan on transferring to a four-year university to get my master's in business management and sports management.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
You said a Florida school, so you're not going to leave the state.
No, that's a lot of money, so you always, it's an opportunity, it's a better opportunity, but, you know, I just want to be able to stay close to home and be able to be my mama.
Well, the bottom line is this. All education is good.
Yes.
All schools are good. And you said it's not the best to stay home. Hey, it's best to stay wherever you can to be able to reach the goals that you are looking for. Let's talk about the date and time, because I think that's part of this drill also.
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, the date is February 25th. That's about a week from yesterday. And it's at Michael's on East, where it's always been the last 3 years. This is our fourth annual. And our attempt is always to make it the fourth Saturday in February, so everybody gets accustomed to it being that date. We got bumped last year because of a big wedding and reception that we couldn't compete with in terms of dollars and cents for what Michael's would bring in. But that's our goal every year, is to try to have it on the fourth Saturday of February, because it's also kind of like the end of Black History Month.
Mm-hmm.
Let me just elaborate a little bit more on Troy's double dipping, because I think it's important that your audience understand that the scholarship was primarily set up within Light of the World, because the church congregation is what supports it. And when Troy talks about double dipping, he was actually, as he said, one of the essay winners, and he also made an application to the scholarship committee that's set up within the church, which is what we're a part of. So that's how he was able to double dip. But having said that, we have been collaborating with other agencies and organizations and groups in the last couple of years, so that we're expanding the scholarship to, for example, the Y Achievers program. We've given two $500 scholarships in the last couple of years to them. Melanie Thomas's Greatness Beyond Measure program, we've given two $500 scholarships to them on an annual basis. And next year we'll be collaborating with Take Stock in Children with their scholarship fund, as well as a community foundation scholarship fund. Because our ultimate goal, and our pastor says it all the time, is that our ultimate goal is to give a full ride scholarship. So this collaboration with Take Stock in Children, I think, is going to allow us to do that.
We really, it started as something very much in-house for mm-hmm. members and our kids within the Light of the World family, but it's grown to something much greater than that and beyond that. And it's really something that we want to see impact our community at large. And it's doing that.
Yes.
And it's growing every year. So we're very excited about that.
So Troy was not the only one who learned how to double dip.
That's right.
Yeah. The scholarship committee.
Right.
And collaborate.
That's right.
Well, and we've also had some other double dippers in church too. Deja DeBose, for example, the year before Troy, she was our top essay winner in 2000.
She was my year.
Troy, and because she's a member of the church, she also applied to the church for scholarship awards, and she also double dipped. We've had
Melissa Moore.
Who else?
Melissa Moore
also. But I mean, as Delilah said, we want to expand it, and eventually, once we build the funds up to where we would like for them to be, we just like to open it up to minority students all over.
Absolutely.
The essay contest.
Mm-hmm.
It's not confined to the church.
Oh, no, not
no,
at
no.
all. No, we put that out to all the schools, Manatee County as well. In fact, one of the winners, in the last couple of years, we've had winners from Manatee County. And we've got some great essays this year. I'm really excited about the essay submissions that we have this year. Some really
bright
kids.
And if I remember correctly from some other program when Troy was here, you attend school in Manatee County.
Yes, I'm actually a proud member of Dean Manatee High School alma mater.
Oh,
yes,
proud member of the Manatee County.
Yes, sir.
There was a time a little while back you'd have to run all the way back to Manatee County. You know that, don't you?
Yes, sir.
So let me get this straight and for our viewers. There's the annual essay contest.
Yes.
That you have, and there are three winners, first, second, and third.
Right.
And minority students from every school in the two counties
yes.
have an opportunity to submit an essay.
Absolutely.
Okay, now, and for those seniors, I take it, mm-hmm. who are attending Light of the World, the church has a scholarship also that goes not with that package, but a scholarship program.
That's right. You got it.
And since it costs so much money to go to school, and I'll say that because, you know, you all have two lovely young daughters, and
yes,
and they are close in ages.
Mm-hmm. They are.
So you're going to have two in school at some point at the same time.
Yes, we will.
Okay, folk. So now, if you want to be supportive of this event, how many years has it been?
This will be our fourth year. The fund was established in 2013, and we had our first fundraiser luncheon in 2014.
Once again, and we're going to say this a couple of times, because mm-hmm. you know, some people don't get up at the same time, and they'll hear the program, but they won't know what the drill was.
Right. Right.
So one of you give us the date and time, place.
Saturday, February 25th at Michael's on East, 11:30. We would be happy to see you there. Come out and support. It's always, always a wonderful program. We have great entertainment there, great food, of course, Michael's on East. And it's, we think, for a wonderful cause.
And so since there are a few days left before the event, mm-hmm. let's talk about, can they call Cravettes a Light of the World?
They can call me at Cravettes, or they can actually go online to ajeanbaptistscholarship@gmail.com and make an RSVP reservation there and then pay at the door. So we're trying to make it as easy as possible to come. But we don't want anybody showing up without a reservation.
Right.
But just go to ajeanbaptistscholarship@gmail.com and they can put their reservation in there, and then they can pay at the door when they come.
Okay,
now cash, credit card.
Now, some of you all out there are looking at that full screen, and we're going to have the full screen at the end of the program as well as within the program. So the next time I come up, it's almost like a drill.
Yes.
If you didn't have your pencil and paper,
get
your pencil
now.
And paper ready.
Right.
So let's talk about how it got started.
Every year at graduation time, Pastor would stand up and said, okay, we've got seniors graduating, so I need you all to put something in these kids' hands. And while Gene and I always did that, we would look at each other and say, you know, this is something that the church should be doing. So upon her passing, and with her spending so much time in the Sarasota County School System, 30 years, and her love for children, I couldn't think of a better way to continue her legacy than to start this scholarship fund. So I started the fund with a $10,000 seed from my personal money, and we put it in the hands of the Community Foundation. So the scholarship is, the fund as it's called, is managed by the Community Foundation. And because of that, it has grown exponentially over the last 4 years that we've had it established. So that's how it all got started, and you know, that's where it's continuing, and it's continuing to grow.
Let's talk about Ms. Thomas, Melanie mm-hmm. Thomas's program. I have been to that program when you have been teaching young folk how to dress. What about that program?
Well, I just love the program that Melody does, because it's all about taking these kids and giving them well-rounded programs to talk about, for example, dressing. They have programs or sessions on careers. They have sessions on etiquette. It's just a well-rounded program, and it's some of the great, better kids that come out to her program. And I thought it was another good way for us as a church to expand the scholarship, you know, opportunities, if you will.
Mm-hmm. While we were talking about this, and since we were talking about teaching people to dress. Here's time for a plug for that place down off of Pineapple.
A shameful plug. Thank you, Doc. Well, I'm president owner of Cravats Custom Clothiers. We've been in business now 27 years this past February. And, you know, for whatever your wardrobe needs might be, come and see us. We'll take very good care of you, I promise.
All right. And that's Cravats?
Cravats, and we're at 1530 Dolphin Street. I like to call it a design studio because it really is what it is. You come in, you choose your fabric, we measure you, and you get your clothes designed exactly the way you want.
All custom.
All custom made, yes. Mm-hmm. And except for accessories, of course.
And all, I and all the accessories.
Yes.
Like you have now.
Yes.
Ties and,
yes.
And pocket squares.
Pocket squares, shoes, cufflinks.
And then there's the other program.
Yes. Yeah.
With
wine.
YMCA Achievers.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Yes, we've also been partnering with the YMCA Achievers program, which is a great program through the YMCA. Baba Hanga has provided mentoring through that program for many years. And, you know, as we look to expand the reach of the scholarship fund and affect the greater community beyond the walls of Light of the World, we don't need to reinvent the wheel. There are great organizations already doing great work. And so we'd rather partner with them to expand our reach, and that's what we're doing with the YMCA Achievers with Greatness Beyond Measure, and looking forward to possibly other partnerships with Take Stock in Children. Mm-hmm. That's something that we have in the works for next year, and other organizations. So we're very excited about the growth and the greater impact that we're having by holding hands, really, with other great organizations.
You know, I like that, holding hands with other great organizations. Which is, you know, that's something, community, time for my lecture now, that we need to do more of as
Absolutely.
A community. Whether it's with the children, whether it's with our political base, whether it's with our religious base. Mm-hmm. We don't have to try to be, I'm number one, you number two. If we, I believe we could achieve so much more if we would just hold hands and let community be what community really means, a coming together of all of us. And I'm glad we have you all here today.
Well, let me, you know, that's a great idea what you're talking about, and let me just give you an example of how that worked perfectly. You go back for years, I was on the Community Foundation's board of directors, and we had grant committees, which I was on one of the grant committees. And during the downturn, or what was called the Great Recession, charitable organizations were really struggling. And one of the things that we did as a board at the Community Foundation was we started collaborating with different organizations and started putting organizations together who were doing the same kind of like work. And it made things transition so much easier. And one example is all of the arts organizations that we have, especially the performing arts organizations, all the theaters, the opera, the orchestra. We came up with a central box office where everybody could go online and order through that one box office, and everybody benefited from it. So the more we collaborate, the stronger we are. Young Henry Porter said something at one of his speeches that resonated with me, and he said, one is too small a number to do anything great. And I thought, wow, how powerful. Mm-hmm. So the more we collaborate with each other, the better off we're all going to be.
And the stronger our community
is. And the stronger our community is going to be. And the more kids we're able to help get into school.
Yes.
How many youngsters have you all touched through your programs, whatever they may be?
We've helped right around 20 students and given awards equaling about $12,000 mm-hmm. since the start of the scholarship fund.
You're too young to know this. Mama knows already that it takes a lot of money to go to school.
Yes.
Whatever school you go to, even when you're at home at community college. And so you're going to be remember this, and you're going to be one of the first to scholarship winners to give back to the scholarship, right?
Yes. One thing I do want to also say is for high school seniors, though, one thing you always want to remember, don't be afraid to apply, because at the end of the day, you know, school is something that's very important, because we want to be able to better our education to become something in life instead of just becoming the next football player, basketball player, next rapper. You know, we have to be able to educate ourselves in something else. You know, my dad always tells me, you always have to have a plan B if your plan A doesn't fall through. So being able to be part of the scholarship is very important to me, because I've always wanted the opportunity to become something with my life and do something with my life. I was born in New Orleans, Louisiana, and moving here, I just wanted to be able to, it was a fresh start. And starting college is also a new fresh start, because it's gonna help me expand my life and be able to know that I can do something better in my life than what it is now.
Mm-hmm. I think you're ready to start mentoring now.
Yes.
What about the in-house mentor that they can see, whether Sunday at church or...
I have people like Mr. Batty and Mr. Lila here that helps me, you know, stay on the right path. You know, if I ever need any help, you know, I can always call them, I can text them and say, hey, I need help with this, I need help with that. You know, they've always been there from middle school to keep me on the right path, so I can be able to just stay focused and know what I want to do with my life.
But it sounds like you can help of the other youngsters, because maybe you don't know, but sometimes youngsters will respond to someone who's just a little older than them, because some like to say, well, they're old. You just don't understand.
Right.
Oh, no? You apparently never was a child, right? You just don't understand. But there are those who listen to you, and then you can move them on to help them listen to the adults.
Yes.
I think he just did a good mentoring job to any seniors or high school kids who are out there listening today on
right
the show.
Now.
Exactly.
I agree with you.
That's right.
So, what did you say you were going to major in when you go to school?
Business management and sports management.
Okay. So all of those football players and basketball players,
right,
you got nothing against them.
No.
Matter of fact, you should probably be their agent, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I love football with a passion, so just being in that field is just going to be one of the awesome experiences for me.
Mm-hmm. And business management.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. You're going to be one of the team owners. I got it.
That's right.
Once again, the event is
Saturday, February 25th, 11:30, Michael's on East.
And for ticket information, you can call
where?
Or go online?
Mm-hmm. At AgeneBattyScholarship@gmail.com. Put in your reservation and bring your check or your credit card to the event. And that needs to happen by the 22nd.
Okay.
So it's not a lot of time, but you still have time to do it. So.
And as much as you love them, you don't really want any walk-ups, because you may walk up and be disappointed.
Yes.
Because there's such thing as giving a head count, is that what it's
called? Yes, what you have to do. We don't want anybody coming hungry and not being able to eat. Yeah.
And be upset
that they
because
couldn't get in.
You didn't follow these great instructions that you get here.
One of the other things I'd like to talk about as far as the fun, Dr. James, is that it's ongoing. And Troy, for example, is a good example of this. As long as they're members of Light of the World and they're in school in good standing, they can apply for scholarship money every year. We don't just give them money initially to start out, because school is ongoing and we want that support to be ongoing.
Mm-hmm.
I'll tip my hat to myself, because that was one of the... components of the Achievers program that I suggested and was implemented years ago. So in the Achievers program also, they can go and get money as every year as long as they're in school. However, there's some issues going on right now. I'm sure you're probably aware that the YMCA Foundation has been disbanded. And that's where a lot of the Achievers money was coming from. Most of it is for scholarship money. So there's some legalities going on with that right now. But the idea that we still have money in the pot for our kids to continue their education as long as they're in school. And again, we hope to open that up to kids all over. But it's just a matter of building the funds. So folks, we need you to come out and support us so that we can expand this.
That's right. Yeah.
Join hands.
Yes.
As community.
Yes.
And help us expand.
Yes.
And that's also interesting. There are enough good programs like this that we should support.
Exactly.
Rather than sit home and complain. Complain about the children. Complain about education. Mm-hmm. Complain about a lack of this, a lack of that. What have you done today? So you got a minute left. Either one of you can take us out.
Well, again, we'd like for you to come out and support us in this great effort to help our children get into school. And you'll also get a great program. We've got some great essays that we are looking forward to hearing at the luncheon. And the other thing we always do is we load up our program with children. You know, they deserve the plugs. So
all right.
They have it down to a science now.
And you are training up in light of the world MCs, I see.
Yeah.
You know, for most of those in our viewing audience who've been watching us at some point in these 44 years, you've gone to a program where Hank was the MC, Mr. MC.
That's right.
And it's good for that too, that we train for.
Absolutely.
And what's that famous parable? Raise
train
up children.
A child in the way that you would have him go, and when he's old, he will not depart from it.
And as always, Suncoast, you have a great day and do the right thing. Support this program.
It's Tampa's most exclusive event of the year, and you're invited. The Morgan Auto Group Charity Polo Classic is back Saturday, February 25th at DI Polo Tour in Plant City. One unforgettable day of luxury and sport with cuisine from Tampa Bay's finest restaurants. Plus, every ticket sold helps a local charity, including the Children's Cancer Center, Ryan Neese Foundation, Close to Kids, and Morgan Auto Group's Helping Hand Fund. Don't miss the Morgan Auto Group Charity Polo Classic. Visit charitypoloclassic.com for tickets and information.
Attention blood clot filter patients. Surgically implanted blood clot filters are potentially life-threatening. Some filters are prone to breaking, resulting in pieces of the filter moving through the body and causing internal bleeding. If you had surgery to implant a blood clot filter, you may be entitled to a cash award, even if you haven't suffered side effects yet. Call the Gold Shield Group now, 888-747-5291, to see if you qualify for a cash award, 888-747-5291.